your word, for your presence. I give you praise, honor, and glory. And I thank you that this word is going to remove every wrong word that has come in opposition to you. And I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. The scripture tells us in Acts 1:8, it says, I better read it, I'm so drunk right now. It says that, and you will receive power after the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you will be my witnesses, witnesses unto me. And it's going to be in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and in the uttermost part of the world. And I declare unto you that there's a power, a fresh anointing being poured out upon us in this hour to be witnesses unto him like never before. That there's going to be just an acceleration and an increase. And please lift up your hands and receive this word. For the Lord says, surely there's going to be an increased anointing upon you to witness unto me, that people will know that I am because of the way you are. Whoo! That people will know that I have because of the way you have. Because people will know that I say, because of the way you walk in salvation. People will know that I heal because of the way you walk in your healing. People will know that I deliver because of the way you walk in deliverance. People will know because you are going to be living proofs that I am the Lord your God. Hallelujah! 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 I release this word upon you. It's time for us to have our lives be in such a way that the world know that we belong to him. For us to be witnesses unto him like never before. What kind of witnesses are we? I remember the Lord, one day he said, are you a witness for the persecution, persecution or for the defense? Lord, what do you mean? He said, your faith is on trial. My existence, people are questioning. They're trying to find something to prove that I don't exist. You belong to me, and your life is to be a witness. Hallelujah. Said your enemy is the accuser. Your enemy has great persecution coming against you. My God. He said, what kind of witness are you? Woo! My God. I said, Father, without your power from on high, I cannot be a witness of any kind. Without your power from on high, I cannot stand in the midst of things I need to stand on. Without your power coming upon us, we cannot be a good witness that people will know that our God saves, our God delivers, our God provides, our God is here for us without us going through some things. And it's in the midst of the things that you are going through. Your witness is not that you don't go through some things. Your witness is that you go through some things, my God, praising the Lord, being a witness that there's something that you believe on the inside of you, that there's this life inside of you, that you know your God. You are alive because he is alive. Apart from him, you wouldn't even be here. Yay! The Spirit of the Lord bears witnesses that you are a son of God. You are a child of God. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter. My God, it doesn't matter. You know, there's different kind of witnesses. Hallelujah. There's eyewitnesses in a courtroom. And this is like a courtroom. And you know, your life is like the world is a courtroom. And you belong to the Lord, and everything that comes against you comes to just question the existence, the reality of God. And I'm asking you, what kind of witness are you showing? Hallelujah. If you're an egg, don't throw me any potatoes. But if you're an egg and things come at you, do you scramble? I couldn't help myself. All right. Because the Spirit of the Lord bears witness that we are children of God, and an eyewitness in a courtroom is someone that is called upon the stand. And I'm telling you, there's a high calling in God. A high calling that the Spirit of the Lord is putting you in situations that it's not about the situation, is that you are being called to the stand. You're being called to the stand. Oh my, you're being called, just like you see in the courtroom. Well, no, we have a witness that says God is alive. We have one witness, and it's an eyewitness. They had seen it. They have heard it. They are walking in it. They know that they know that they know. They're not just a hearsay witness. They're not a hearsay witness. They don't believe. Their testimonies is not because of what God has done to somebody else, but it's not even because of what they can say. But their lives, their walk show that God is alive. The way they walk shows that their God is alive. The way they talk, the way that they don't melt under pressure, the way that they should already have gotten a nervous breakdown, but instead of a breakdown, they're waiting for their breakthrough because they know that their God is on their side, because they know that their God's going to work all things together for the good to them who are called to the stand. They're called to stand. Yes, we are such witnesses when the Spirit of the Lord comes upon you, when the Spirit bears witness with your spirit that you are a child of God. There might be some fires you walk through, but you know you're just walking through them. There might be some things that comes at you, and you might hear the enemy constantly cross-examine you. But for every cross-examination, the work of the cross works. For every cross-examination, the Lord, he comes, and because of what he has done on the cross, he brings incredible things upon your life. You know why? I found out a long time ago that every time I stand by faith, every time my life is a witness that God is alive for anything that you go through. Fiery darts in your body, fiery darts in your family, your finances, things that you're going through. It doesn't matter what it is. In the world, you will have tribulation. In the world, you will have much persecution and persecution. People will come against you and persecute you, even if you don't do anything. Just because you're a child of God, you will get mad. Somebody will get mad because of the power that you carry. Somebody will come against you because you belong to God. Make no mistake, it's not easy to witness without the power of the Holy Spirit. Peter and John, They went to the beautiful gate and they healed this man that was in the gate, you remember. And they told him, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. What you're asking for, we don't have. What you're asking for, we don't have. But in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And then they put them in an incredible court situation. and get so mad at them. Well, what gives you the right? Well, what do you mean somebody got healed and you're tripping with me? Somebody in your life has been watching you and growing in faith, in healing. So the enemy is coming against you, cross-examining you. Throwing some things in your head, in front of you, in your life, asking you, what gives you the right? Well, what makes you think you're a child of God? Well, what makes you think you have the right to witness to others when your life is not 100% perfect? What gives you the right, oh God? What gives you the right to lay hands on the sick while you yourself are sick in your body? What gives you the right? Oh, my God. Where there's some things that come against you. You know what happened in that story? They stand strong, and the people realize that because they say, no, you don't understand. We're not doing this in our own name. It's in the name of Jesus. It's not even, in other words, you can't try to come against who we are, but you cannot come against who he is. You cannot do anything about who he is. We stand strong into who he is. Why do you come to us as though we had anything to do with this? We have nothing to do with this. The way that we stand as a single parent raising kids, the way that we stand in the midst of looking for work when there is no work, the way that we stand in the midst of fiery darts in our body, even though our body is in pain, we rise up and walk in healing because we believe that in the name of Jesus, every weapon that formed against us, every fiery dart, nothing will prosper. That is just a matter of time. So we stand, we are witnessing unto him, because Peter and John, they were not tripping out and they were not scrambling. They were not scrambling. They were standing strong, and they started moving with so much boldness. And even the scripture tells us that they saw that they were uneducated, unrestrained. They were nobodies according to the world. They were nobodies. And it says, and they saw their boldness. And the scripture tells us in Acts, and it says they saw that it was because they had been with Jesus. They had been with Jesus. And it gave them boldness, this assurance. This assurance. You know, the enemy will, in cross-examination, he will use the opposite and bring you so much insecurity. Insecurity is what he uses to just tear down people. So that then people don't walk in boldness. The key is always to spend time with Jesus, and you only can spend time with him if you know that he is. And if you know that he is, if you believe that he is, then you know he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him, with those who believe that God is. When things come against you, your greatest witness is that you a witness for him. It doesn't say necessarily that you witness for him. You witness to him. Your life is a witness. You're living proof. Without Jesus, we wouldn't have known that Father existed. The Trinity works so well together that Jesus said, you have seen me, you've seen the Father. I'm a witness. The Holy Spirit, everything that pertains to the Son, the Holy Spirit reveals and brings forth for us to know. And now we, because by the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, we are witnesses. That we are a member, therefore the head exists. Your life is a living proof. Living proof. If you think of yourself in a courtroom, you know, if you've ever watched and see something, or I don't know, what is it called? We won't tell nobody that you know the word, Deacon Leroy. If you ever watch NCIS and you see people in a courtroom and there's something to solve and there's always a question. There's always a question, is this person guilty or is this person innocent of a crime? Well, here, our lives, we have been found already not guilty. Doesn't mean we're perfect, but listen, we are not guilty. The moment that you are born again, you have been declared not guilty. In the world, you stand in cross-examination with people that don't understand that. How can God exist and you still go through some stuff? My answer is always, well, listen, you didn't know me before. I used to go through even more stuff. But before, I didn't have no power that was coming against me to help me walk through it, to help me stand through it, to help me be strong and believe that God is. So no, I look back and I know that I'm a witness. That's like, I think we're all becoming expert witnesses. We expert witnesses. We're the witnesses that they call because we have so much expertise in knowing how God pulls people out of the mess. We have so much expertise knowing how God makes a way out of no way. We have so much expertise knowing that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. We are expert witnesses. We don't scramble when the going gets tough, but we receive even an increased power to walk even in greater glory because our God, He calls us to give Him glory everywhere we are. He says, do all to the glory of God. I see a glorious church. I see a glorious church. I see glorious people of God walking in all glory, that some things don't even bother them. I believe that that's why the enemy has so battled some members of the body of Christ in leadership these last, I don't know how many years, last years. That you hear a leader that have been caught doing this or doing that. Why do you think it is? It's to tear down their witnessing. But not just theirs. Because we are members. When one suffer, we all suffer. When one rejoice, we all rejoice. It's amazing how the media just lay a hold of anything that happens that comes against the witness that God is real so quick. We should start a news program of all the praise report of everything God does. It should be headlines when God heal you and save you and touch your child. It's because it just messes up your testimonies. The enemy just tried to tempt people. If I go out of a club on Colfax, and if I leave the club, and I bump into 10 cars, and I get into my car, and I bump into a pole, what witnessing? If I'm in the courtroom, well, Dr. J, I thought your God was real. How come you were seen on Colfax and where are their bars there? 15th, 16th, 15th? No, 15th is Colfax, where you catch my drift. You get caught on such place, blah, 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 blah. What can you say for your defense? The attorney, he's in the courtroom. by His Spirit. In the courtroom, you hear a song. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? And you see one person over here stand up and said, I'm a witness. I remember when I messed up, but my God, He forgave me. He helped me. He washed me clean. I remember when by His grace I stood. I remember I'm a witness. And then another one stand up, I'm a witness. I can tell you I've seen God move and restore people. I've seen Him set the captives free. I'm a witness. Hallelujah. Then another one stand up. I'm a witness. I know what it is to be bound, but God can set the captives free. I'm a witness. And as all the testimonies come forth, that person, I'm using this example, but that person suddenly rise up in faith. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I can make it. Yeah, I still belong to God. And then, in addition to all the people rising up, something happened, the greatest witness. The Spirit bears witness that we are children of God. And the Holy Spirit starts stirring up. And you know what just happened? Because of the witness of the people, then one was able to stand and know, no, there's witnesses, and now I'm going to be one of them. Hallelujah. And I know that my God is able. I've seen my God the moment that you praise Him in the midst of something because you remember what you witnessed Him to do before the last time. I've seen Him do incredible things. I believe that some people, sometimes they fall in the wrong thing because they don't have enough witnesses around them. And they keep things to themselves, and they don't have anybody to help them stand. See, we're in church today, not because we are perfect, but because we are the church. There's some people coming from the highways and the byways into this house and many houses that they need the brothers and the sisters to be witnesses. That's why the power of God is being released in this season. That's why the Spirit of the living God is being released to give you power to be witnesses like never before. In the way you say things and the way you walk. And you know, to witness, you don't necessarily have to speak. It's an incredible way that you can stand with joy that you can't explain, even though you go through stuff. It's not because you have a smile on your face that people think that you don't go through something. You don't necessarily have to have your body shows you going through some things. The enemy tried to get you so oppressed. But the moment that you are a witness, the moment that you remember that your God is alive and you spend just 2 seconds with Jesus, the moment that you see Him high and lifted up, the Holy Spirit bears witness. And that very moment, whatever situation you are in, you know what happens? Heaven puts you in a witness protection program. That very moment, He picks you up. That very moment, you're in the midst of a situation, you can't pay your bills, or you're bound by something, or you're sick in your body, or you're worried, or whatever situation is, or you've been waiting on God for a breakthrough, it doesn't matter. You're standing there, and the very moment that instead of saying, I don't know, I'm not sure if God's going to do it, and I don't know if really He heard my prayers, and I really don't know, I'm tired to wait on God, and God this, and God that, and God, no. No. 9. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? I forgot the song. But I remember that part. But the moment I've noticed, you know, and sometimes because of people being people of faith, we might not say what's going on. But there's the other extreme. The witnessing is you going through some things. You don't have to tell any details. But you can say, hey, I'm going through some things. But I tell you what. I know that God is. I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that the one who redeems me is with me to deliver me, to walk all things together for my good. Even though it may not look like it, I'm going to stand. You can cross-examine me, devil. You can cross-examine me, brothers and sisters. I stand by faith. I stand with faith. I stand by grace. I believe that Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. So watch me, because I'm going through it. I'm going through it. I'm being a witness for such a time as this. I'm a living proof. And I can remember the last time that God did this and God did that. And the moment that you do that, woo! 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 There's a witness protection program. There's angels. There's the Holy Spirit. There's other laborers. There's things just starting to come and move in your life to protect you, to put you in a place that you can just abide, be still, and know that God is God. Rest in Him. Stand still and see the salvation of your Lord. Stand still and see your God move. Stand still in that place, because you don't have to worry. You're in a new glory program, I call it. That you're being protected. That very moment, it's like there's big walls that come all around you. You being put in a place is that scripture in John 15 that says, if my word abide in you and you abide in my word, you will ask whatsoever you will. And it says, and it shall be done unto you. There's a scripture that says, if you deny me in front of others, I too will deny you. And of course, there's some scriptures like this. It talks about salvation. But it also talks that there's some times that you need to be a witness in situation and say, I'm not denying that I'm a child of God. This is the time that I'm speaking it forth like never before. I'm a child of God. Hallelujah. I belong to Him. I confess Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! He's my Lord and Savior. So I'm asking you today, because you know when you complain and all this stuff, and we all go through that as we grow into the knowledge of who He is from glory to glory. It's kind of fearful, some situations we find ourselves in. But I don't want to be a witness for the persecution. I don't want my life and what I say and what I do to be an excuse for the world. They're looking for an excuse to say God doesn't exist. I don't want it to be because of something that I... Hallelujah. I don't want to be a witness. I remember a time in my life that if people would look at my life, they would be able to say the devil exists. I was a living witness for the persecution. Hallelujah. Anybody could have just, yeah, look, the devil is all in her life. But now? Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Stand up! Let me say that again, because I feel like I'm on Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Go ahead and witness. Say, yes, Lord. I believe you, my Savior, my Lord, my King, my healer, my deliverer. I'm a witness. I'm a living proof. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Empower me to witness. I give you praise. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. I bless you today. I pray everywhere you go today that you will remember this word, that you will be a witness because of the peace and the love and the joy that you walk in. Hallelujah. And I just bless you. And if you have to pick up the kids at 11, I don't even know what time it is. I'm so drunk. Good. If you have to pick up your kids, I want to pray for you first. And if you're here for the first time, I want to bless you. I feel the power from on high. When the Lord brings forth the word, he always brings forth an anointing for the word that he released. And the word is that I will give you a power from on high to be a witness unto me. So come and receive power from on high. Hallelujah.